Vaping has become more popular among teenagers than smoking cigarettes, and that may be due to some misconceptions about it. Yes, it's true, vaping is not as bad for you as smoking, but that doesn't mean that it is harmless. Today, Life's Biggest Questions asks, is vaping bad for you? Hello and welcome back to LBQ. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in those comments what topics you would like to see next. Also, there is a very high chance that we may have answered a topic suggestion that you have, so please make sure you check out the videos tab. Smoking cigarettes is the consumption of carbon monoxide and over 70 other cancer-causing substances. Nicotine is not necessarily the problem, though it is addictive. It's the smoke that's inhaled that contributes to the toxic nature of smoking. Smoking is the leading cause of preventable death in the United States. 500,000 people die as a result of cigarettes every year. It's an extremely addictive habit that's overwhelmingly difficult to kick. But many smokers have found vaping, or electronic cigarettes, to be a safer alternative to smoking, and it has actually helped them kick the habit. Vapes, or e-cigarettes, consist of a cartridge and a battery. When they are turned on, they heat up the liquid in the cartridge, causing it to turn into vapor. That vapor is then inhaled. Some people who choose to vape choose to do so without nicotine. Instead of the 70 toxic chemicals associated with smoking, vaping only releases nicotine and several relatively harmless chemicals. But vaping is still a relatively new thing. Its long-term effects are still being studied and debated. According to a recent study done by researchers at New York University School of Medicine, vaping is still dangerous and should not be promoted as safe, especially where adolescents are concerned. The study found that vaping could mutate DNA and therefore increase the risk of cancer and heart disease. Researchers exposed mice to vapor from e-cigarettes, and the mice who were exposed to the vapor had higher levels of DNA damage than the mice who were exposed to just normal filtered air. The researchers also exposed vapor to cultured human lung and bladder cells and found similar results. The DNA repair systems that are responsible for protecting the body against cancer were also weakened by the vapor from e-cigarettes. The study's leader, Dr. Moonshong Tang, said that e-cigarette smoke is carcinogenic, and e-cig smokers have a higher risk than non-smokers of developing lung, bladder cancer, and heart disease. It can be concluded then that there are still risks associated with vaping, most notably when you're vaping with nicotine. E-cigs still deliver some of the same toxins as cigarettes, like formaldehyde, nitrosamines, and lead. And although these toxic chemicals are 9 to 450 times lower in vapor than in cigarette smoke, they still exist. What's more is, many people who vape do so very frequently, increasing the amount of chemicals inhaled. Still, if it's a choice between smoking and vaping, obviously choose the latter. Vaping can really help people quit smoking. According to current studies, if American smokers switch to e-cigarettes over the next 10 years, that could save 6.6 million lives. That's according to David Abrams, professor of social and behavioral sciences at NYU. Similarly, the Royal College of Physicians in the UK also reported that e-cigarettes are 95% less harmful than smoking. So to answer the question, is vaping bad for you? I mean, it's not good for you. Of course, the best route to a healthy lifestyle is not to vape or smoke at all. Men who've taken up vaping as a habit have done so not necessarily because they want to quit smoking, but because they're under the impression that vaping is completely safe. But if you are a smoker, and if using a vape or an e-cig will help you kick your smoking habit, well, that's alright with us. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you want to go on an LBQ binge, why not check out our playlist Biggest What Ifs, clickable on that screen right now. As always, make sure you turn on notifications by clicking the bell, and we'll see you in another video.